Here is the painting we're going to try and do today. Well, we are going to do this today. So if you like the look of it, please stay tuned and I'll show you how I've done it. Hope you like it. And please subscribe. Thank you very much. Thank you. Bye bye. Right, here's the colours I'm using. I've got magenta, Naples yellow, white, turquoise, ultramarine and royal blue. And those are the colours we're going to be using today. I might even add one of these two, but I'll let you know halfway between when I'm doing the painting. Okay, so let's get back to the painting. Now the first thing is, this is 16 by 20 inch plywood, 5.5 milli thick, and been gessoed 3 times to give it a nice flat smooth finish. And the next thing I'm going to do is to put the line on for the horizon. Now you don't want it right up here, you don't want it right down there, and you don't want it in the centre. You just want it off centre. It's nice and square on the edge. Line it up nice and straight. And then, let's have a look. That's it. And then put a line across. So that's where we're going with the horizon line. Next, I'm going to be using a palette knife. That's a Bob Ross one, actually, and that's just a normal small knife. And mainly a flat brush. That's a 3/4 14. Yeah. Right, so what I'll do first is mix some, you can't see it off camera I'm afraid, but I'm going to mix some blue, only a little bit to start with, and then I'm going to apply that like that. Just give it a bit of colour. And I'm going to be using linseed oil, which I put into a dispenser like that, just a soap, and just squirt that out. And the other thing I do, I use a lot of these yogurt containers for holding me linseed oil in, so I can just dip it in. Okay. Now I'm putting some pure blue on. Whoops. Just spilt the linseed oil everywhere then. I'm putting pure blue on now. This is royal blue. And then a bit of carillion. Yeah, like that. A bit of ultramarine. Just mixing with it. A bit more white. Linseed oil and my brush and just mix it around. What are you doing? You're just mixing it about and just so it just all blends together. Nice and easy. A bit more linseed. This just makes it a bit more liquidy. Just like that. That's it. That's the way to do it. Okay, you just need to nice and relaxed. Like that. Yeah. Doesn't matter if you go slightly over the line, because you're going to go over the water afterwards. So it's just to give it a quick colour. Now don't wash your brush out, keep your brush as it is. And then what you need to do is, now on this I've got ultramarine and a bit of turquoise. let's mix it together. Turquoise, because it goes green, as you can see. I'm just trying to blend it out. We're just trying to get a bit of variation, the cloudy. It'll be a bit darker down there, so what we'll do there, we'll put some ultramarine in there. That's it. That's it. It's very, very strong, so you don't need a lot of this. I'm doing them sort of strokes. You can see. Just blend it in nice. And that's it. Yeah. And then I'm going to use some Naples yellow and just double it on. Like that. Yeah, same again, nice and easy. Just hardly touching the board. Hardly touching. A little bit of magenta. That again, hardly touching. Trying to get like a sunset-y type scene. A little bit more. This end. Nice and easy, just very, very gently, hardly touching it. Just got to blend them together. Okay, and then we'll go a little bit darker, I think, at the top. It looks a bit too light, so we're going ultramarine. Darken it down a bit. Like I say, you've got to be very careful with this. You can always lighten it up again with a bit of white, which we'll probably do in a few minutes because it might be too dark yet, I don't know. I'm trying to create a bit of a mood on the painting if we can. That's not looking too bad, that actually, is it? Yeah, that's not bad, not bad at all. Look. Then, give me a brush a quick wipe. Excuse me. And a paper towel. Just take the excess off. That's all. And just give it a quick more, a little bit more blending. And then if you think it's too dark, you can light it up by putting a bit of white on. Just that's all you have to do. Just make sure you wipe your palette knife. And then again. Bit more. Bit more at this end. A It should go to the edge. Otherwise it looks false. Wipe my brush again. And just blend it in. Barely touching the board. Just skimming over the top, just moving the paint about. That's all we're doing. Nothing else. I think we'll lighten it up a little bit round here. If you can't see me off camera, all I'm doing is getting some paint off the board, off the mixing palette. Keep the paint moving, mixing up. As long as you don't press too hard, otherwise you'll end up with a mess. Which I could end up with a mess yet, which if I do, I'll show you how to get out of that. Just like that, yeah. I think we'll have a bit more white. The trick to it is to keep wiping your brush, otherwise you end up smudging it about everywhere. You end up with a mud mess. New piece of cloth, or towel I should say. And then blend it together. You can add a little bit of dark on it as well by adding a bit of lamp black or any type of black really, whatever you've got handy. That's not painted underneath there either, is it? So what we do there, just mix that a little bit more. Okay. Now, what I'll do now, we're going to take one of these brushes, a bit of white. I'm going to dance it around like that. You see how it's mixed in with the colour? It's mixed in with the colour now, you see, so we have to wipe that. Just tap the hair there. Then some more white. Bit of texture. Wipe the brush again. That. Get as much as the blue off your brush as you can. Some more white. And then just tap it. And as soon as the colour mixes, you have to wipe your brush. Like that. Then we'll go back to the other brush. give it a quick wipe. You know, ideally you could use another brush really, but a new brush. And then just feather it across. Like that. Hardly touch it. You don't want to smudge all the paint everywhere. What you're trying to do is just get rid of them lumps. So you're barely touching. Just like that. Bounce it over. Like that. That's it. And then, I'm going to wet the brush. Back to this brush again. Wipe it again. I think we'll put some more white clouds in. So we give it a quick wipe. And then, tap it on the board. Same again. And I think that is that for the time being. Next we'll go on to the sea. And you can see what that looks like. Oh, got a bit of a lump of paint there. Never mind. That's it. Yeah, I think so. I think that'll do it. Mix that across. Gives it a bit of atmosphere, doesn't it? Right, next time we'll go into the sea. See you shortly.